past week have announced their plans to try to make further observations. I mention this because over the course of the next 2 weeks, they're going to be committing the resources of our stereo instruments, observational instruments. Stereo is an acronym. It stands for the Solar Terrestrial Relations Observatory. And as much as NASA has been trying to convince us of late that LMM is not only there's nothing extraordinary about it, but in fact it's rather a weak or unordinary type comet, that, you know, not interesting at all, and yet they're going to be committing 2 hours of every day during the next 2 weeks. One of the two instruments, the observational instruments of stereo, will be turned. It will perform a 135-degree roll in order to observe comet LMM. Once again, for 2 hours out of each day over the course of the next 2 weeks, which is rather and quite interesting. And I would invite you to go to stereo-ssc.nascom.nasa.gov if you'd like to find out more information about that as well.
You're talking to Crew 14, and I thought I might give the listeners an eyewitness account of what was seen. Basically, we've been following this thing since February, and when I talked with Astro Patriot and I first saw the first video that he showed, had this huge wave of radiation and orbitals were popping out. And I didn't really want to believe it, so I went and bought a scope, a Meade LX200 8-inch scope. And it took me basically until May to get it up and running and figure it out. We still didn't quite have the kinks of the camera part out, but we were able to get some viewing. Right on the 29th, 30th, and 31st of May, it basically was motionless in the constellation of Leo with Regulus as the dominant star. And the alleged comet is over to the left. Over to the right, right around Regulus, there was this huge sort of black area. Black area such that every now and again it would move over, cover Regulus, and you could see the light from Regulus bending over the edge of what we now know as the gravity well. You could see the light bending over their fingers, and then it would move away and you'd see Regulus as a point in the sky. After studying this for some time, I noticed over on the right-hand corner of this dark area, a little red orbital coming out in a bit of a squirrely figure of eight sort of pattern. About then, I started to look up at 12 o'clock, and I saw two more orbitals that popped out. They were white. Then I started looking all around this area, and then over on the left, there were two that were blue that sort of popped in and popped out and popped in and popped out. Also, just underneath here, at about 6 o'clock, were two more white objects or orbitals that were popping out. Now, what's interesting about this, the French, I can't think of the name of their team, but on March 3rd and March 5th, they took a video of this movement across the sky, and it showed all the orbitals. After that, they only showed pictures of the single solitary comet. They didn't show any more time-lapse films. All they did was point to the one area was a comet, and what you really wanted to see was over to the right of that. They didn't take any more pictures of that. I'm sure they saw it. They just didn't take any more pictures. In any event, it scared me so bad that night on the 29th, I immediately called... I immediately spoke with Carol and one of the other members of our group, and I actually asked him not to mention it or anything at that point. I was actually frightened. So the next night, which was the 30th, on a Sunday, I thought, well, I don't believe what I saw. It's not real. I'm going to just forget it. I'll just take a look again. And it was still motionless, and unfortunately, it was still there. The orbitals were still there, the popping out was going on, and this, you know, I became even more frightened, and also I was still a bit in denial, until finally on the third night I said, I'll forget what I saw the last two nights, and I'll look again, this time on the third night. And on the third night, exact same thing. It was still motionless. The orbital cloud, I don't mean the orbital cloud, but the gravity well was still bending light over at Regulus and then moving where you could see Regulus. The red orbital was still coming out, doing a real squirrely orbit. The two on top were there, the two on the left, and the two on the bottom. And, you know, at that point, I couldn't convince myself of that I didn't see what I saw. I'd seen it three nights in a row. It didn't go away, and the consequences of that have caused me to make urgent changes in my life and my habits and so forth. By trade, I'm a physician slash amateur astronomer slash archaeologist and a number of other things, but my main occupation is a physician. I have my own practice, etc. And I've been doing this for 25 years, so I didn't start yesterday. You know, it still makes me tremble to think about what I saw. And then, you know, as time has passed on, we're getting more evidence, more volcanoes are going off, more earthquakes, a 6.7 near the east coast of Japan. They say it's in the sea, and it says it's near the east coast. That's bad enough, but the earthquakes have picked up, the volcanism has picked up, you know, and the weather modification and changes we're having, and we're getting to a point. It's a bit of serendipity, as Tara alluded to before, my calling this particular person and finding out, oh, well, he's getting calls from China, he's getting calls from folks in Arkansas telling him to come right away, not explaining it to him. And I just happened to call because I sent him an email, and I said, hey, I said, you know, I really don't need these. You know, it's not the money, I'll buy something else. And then he got curious. Well, you know, you're in Missouri, he said. And I said, yeah. He said, well, what do you need with, you know, Arctic sleeping bags? And that's when I told him about Ellie, and then it sort of, I guess he had an epiphany, a click as to why the Chinese were urging him to bring his entire family, but not telling them why. Same thing with the group in Arkansas, telling him to come, and they'd given him basically a three-week window. That was a week and a half ago.
Hey, YouTube. Dutch Sense here. It is 1:32 a.m. Central Time on August 2nd, 2011. And I'm over here on Sheila Alien's website, and I want to encourage you guys to jump over here and check it out. She's captured something that I think we all need to take a look at. Bald Mountain, California, and it looks like steam geyser event of some kind occurring up here. Now, I want to point out to you guys while you're looking at this here, and the link is down below, definitely go subscribe up and check out this video. Watch it in HD, and you can really see the amount of steam coming up literally out of the ground. It looks like a forest fire, but it's not. Now, I've looked over the forest fires in the area. They've got them placed on a map on the same website that's offering this webcam here. So definitely it bears looking into, especially with the steam that's coming up right here in these areas. Okay. And on Google Earth, I've marked it out, and here is the Bald Mountains, right? They're called the Bald Hills, and then you have other peaks in the area like Mount St. Helena, Browns Hill, Sugarloaf Mountain, and then up to the north you've got Geyser Peak, Black Mountain, Diana Rock, and when you zoom in on these areas, they are old volcanoes. Okay, you can see the craters. Go look at a few more. Here's Geyser Peak. So, to me, it's another sign.
I didn't try to add up the time to notice that it coincided with the 7th of July and the crossing of Saturn's orbit. You know, my time frame was still is August 1st, but I'm getting more anxious by the day. And so folks need to know this is real. They need to wake up. You know, I'm past the point of trying to wake anybody up. dwellers, and the problem with them is the elevation is too high. You don't want to be that high. You want to get out of that area. There are 4 or 5 volcanoes in New Mexico, and they're all going to blow up and towards that area, so you don't want to be in that ash fallout. There's a volcano that just, I want to say about, it wasn't a volcano, we had an earthquake in Arizona today, about a 3.3. I hadn't seen that recently, so, you know, a number of things are going on. This is unstoppable, it's unavoidable, you cannot escape it, you must seek shelter.
Really quickly, and then continue from the chat room. Wants to know if you're talking about Planet X or Elenin, and I've never thought Elenin is Planet X. Cheryl's pretty stuck on that, but I think Elenin is a result of it. It's a comet that's been kicked in.
Elenin is extinction level event Nibiru is near.
Right.
Does that explain it? Estimated that this thing is traveling around 3,500 miles an hour, okay?
Okay.
That was our estimate of its speed. Now, it has been picking up speed, and that's the reason why we think it's going to arrive early, because when it comes around the backside of the sun, it's got to double that speed in order to attain breakaway speed to leave the sun and not wind up orbiting it. It's never orbited the sun in the past that we know of, so that means that it's going to have to attain breakaway speed to head back out into space. Now, you look at the NASA videos, photos, and all this other crap those morons put on the internet. This thing is coming in. It's going to, as soon as it goes around the top of the sun, it's going to go back out into space.
Right.
And it's going to do this really fast. When it goes past us, it's going to go past us so fast that we'll almost have no time to get ready. That's my opinion. But, you know, just drawing it out on paper a few times and thinking about it, and I went, you know, if this thing picks up enough speed to make breakaway speed, then that means it's going to come past us. You know, this thing, according to what I was told, is that this thing is approximately 47,000 miles in diameter, you know, 4 or 5 times the size of the Earth, and it'll come past us, and we won't have a lot of warning, and we won't get to see it in the sky until it's on us. I think the NASA timeline is completely off. I think this thing is going to arrive much earlier than they say it is. You know, I know they're saying October, but, you know, if you look at the, you know, now, I was told that the poles are not shifting at 42 miles a year. They're shifting at 42 miles a day. And the reason is because this planet is rolling over to face this thing. Now, when it goes by, it's not going to push our North Pole away. It's going to grab our Southern Pole with its Northern Pole. And it's going to be like somebody kicked this planet in the ass. That earthquake that it talks about in Revelations when the opening of the sixth seal comes. From what I've been told, that's very accurate, because that's exactly what's going to happen. There's going to be a massive earthquake when it locks onto us. As it goes past us, we're going to fall right upside down. The oceans are just going to be roaring from pole to pole, as you could well guess they would, because if you take a planet that's 7,000 miles across and roll it upside down in 30 minutes, you're going to have some real serious problems with wind and water. We should be preparing to expect this thing to show up anytime. That's what's going to happen. Hopefully nothing in this mess will hit us, even though it does say it will in the Bible. Leastwise, it does in my Bible. It says we can expect all kinds of problems. We were looking at asteroids right close to this thing. There's asteroids that are floating around right near the, that are orbiting the main sun itself. These things appear to be about 500 miles across. And as you go back into the tail, you get into meteorites that go back for millions of miles in the tail. This thing looks like a giant red teardrop-shaped dust cloud. And you can see, once if you're able to see it up close like we did, you can see every speck out there. I guarantee you there's trillions of meteorites following this thing. Now,
there's no way around it. There's no way to stop it. This thing is for real. It's not going away.